Good morning, students. So we were discussing the poem My Last Duchess. In the last two videos we discussed about the first part of this poem. My Last Duchess, it is a famous dramatic monologue by Robert Browning. Duke, who is a speaker in this poem, Duke, who is the Duke of Ferrara, and a messenger of the neighboring king, Count, has come at his court to talk about the engagement of his master's daughter with Duke. And Duke, he shows the picture, image or portrait of his last duchess to the messenger. And he describes the qualities of his last duchess to the messenger. So next lines, "Sir, it was all one, my favor at her breast. The drooping of the daylight in the west, the bow of carrying some officious food, broke in the orchard. For her, the white moon. She rode me round the terrace, over an inch, would draw from her alike the approving speech, or blush at least. She thanked me good, but thanked somehow, I know not how, as if she reigned by gift of 900 years or name, with anybody's gift, who would stoop to blame this short of tripping." So these are next lines of the poem. "Sir, it was all one." Duke is telling to the messenger about the past qualities which he has already told to him. "Sir, it was all one, my favor at her breast, the drooping of the daylight in the west. Duke had given a gift to the duchess, which she always used to wear at her breast, in which on that ornament she has a symbol of the setting sun in the west." So Duke tells to the messenger, "Sir, I had given her a gift of gold, which had a symbol of setting sun on it, and which she wore on her breast. The boughs of cherries of officious food broke in the orchard for her. I had given her a very expensive gift, but at the same time, very ordinary people of his castle They brought the branches of the trees and they gave to the Jachis. She delivered same smile to them, the smile which she used to deliver, she used to give me. Duke calls the layman officious fool. So that is indirectly Duke is speaking about his own quality. She rode him down the terrace. Not only she accepted the gifts of the ordinary people and she delivered smile to them, but when ordinary people they requested her to ride on the mule, very soon she became happy and she accepted their request and she rode on the white mule round the terrace. So she rode with round the terrace on the white mule on the request of the ordinary people, the servant of the castle, whom Duke calls officious fool. All an age would draw from her alive by a proven speech, and everybody was attracted by her speech, and she delivered a bless to them, and she thanked the people in a very polite manner. Duke is not speaking that she delivered thanks to the ordinary people in a very polite manner, but he is telling that she thanked men, good, but thanked somehow, I know not how. She thanked people, but she thanked them in that way I cannot explain. She thanked the people in very polite manner. I am commenting here as a teacher of English. Duke is not telling. And in that way, as if she read my gift of 900 years old name with anybody's gift, who would stoop to blame this short of it? So in that way, she did not maintain the dignity of my 900 old dynasty. And for that short of rippling, or for that act of rippling, for that tribal act, who would like to give her advice? And who would like to stoop to blame? Means, he tells that I would not like to stoop before her, to blame her, to advise her that you should not do like that. You should maintain the dignity of our dynasty. And if I would advise her, that would be a sort of tripping. So I thought that I would not advise her. So this is the explanation of the lines, And in the next video, we shall discuss the last part of the poem, My Last Lessons. Thank you. Thank you.